What is the most common lump found in a young woman's breast? The answer is a fibroadenoma. What is a fibroadenoma? Fibro, meaning connective or fibrous tissue. Adenoma, meaning glandular-like tissue, or the more medical term is stromal tissue, the kind of connective stuff that's in the breast, and epithelial tissue, the cells that line the ductal system. So of all the lumps and bumps that we find in the breast, fibroadenoma is one of the most common. Its peak age in Caucasian women is in their 20s. Among African American, Hispanic, and other women of color can actually start in the latter part of the teen years. The fibroadenomas arise out of what's called the terminal ductal lobular units, same place, interestingly, that breast cancer arises. And it probably arises because of a lot of unopposed estrogen. So when you think about the development of young women, there's a lot of unopposed estrogen as breasts are growing, things of this sort are happening. And so it's that unopposed estrogen that's probably a causative factor. So quite frankly, in women in their 20s, if I'm sitting in my office and my assistant says, I have a 24-year-old with a palpable lump in the breast, I mean, I have greater than a 95% chance of being right that it is a benign fibroadenoma. Now, since these lumps can have a mixture of tissue, if the tissue mixture is benign and benign, then the overall lesion is completely benign. The fibroadenoma can have some ductal tissue lining inside of it. Even sometimes that ductal tissue can become atypical. And then one of the questions that I've been asked is, hey, can it become cancer? In my own personal career, I've had less than a half a dozen cases where the ductal cells lining the fibroadenoma were early in situ breast cancer. That's really, really unusual, quite rare actually. And if you find that, you really need to make sure there isn't cancer elsewhere in the breast. The other question that I'm commonly asked is, does having a fibroadenoma increase my lifetime risk of breast cancer? Well, because we don't know what causes fibroadenomas, this other than the unopposed estrogen, and we don't know what causes breast cancer, the answer is, in long-term studies, that yes, there is a small increase in lifetime risk of breast cancer, perhaps 2.6 relative risk increase, if you've had a fibroadenoma at a younger age, and then, you know, obviously you need to be followed very carefully over the rest of your life, and you need to be screened regularly anyway. Now, if you then combine that with other family history issues or other related things, then perhaps the incidence can go up somewhat higher. So hopefully this definition of a fibroadenoma is helpful. These are benign. The indication to take them out is if they're getting bigger. Quite frankly, I just took out a very large one today in a lovely small-breasted woman in her 20s. We always want to use the maximum sort of cosmetic approach, remembering that these are young, beautiful women, and we want them to continue to look that way. Always be cognizant that things in the breast, like a fibroadenoma, may have a small increase in lifetime risk of breast cancer. As always, stay heart healthy. As always, follow screening guidelines. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.